Warning: The Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation, home of unprotected thought, borders, language, culture. And here he is.
Stock market gets shut off. No one knows why. The idiot in charge of Homeland Security says it's not an outside actor doing it. You hear this? Jed Johnson, the Department of Homeland Security. He doesn't know what happened, but he knows why it didn't happen. He knows that it's not an outside bad actor who did it. How does he know that? Why don't they wake Obama up and ask him? He knows everything else. He knows how to ruin the military, ruin the schools. Shall I go? But he doesn't know why the stock market suddenly crashed. I know why the stock market crashed, because the gangsters who control the stock market didn't want to lose money. And they saw the trades were coming in such numbers that they would have lost all of their ill gains. So they stopped the trading. That's all. Boss Tweed is alive and well in New York City somewhere. Somewhere in the bowels of New York, Boss Tweed is alive and well. And he didn't like what was happening to his ill. And so he said, you know what, let's just stop the trading, shut the computers down. Well, if it's not him, then it has to be our good friends in China, Obama's good friends, who he's done a deal with. Hillary, of course, and Bill gave China every military secret possible and then some. Yeah. So I don't want to talk about the news. Just talked about the news. The market's reopening in about 4 minutes, and we'll see what happens. I mean, you know, look, the fact is the New York Stock Exchange stopped trading, but NASDAQ. So it's the gangsters running the NYSC. What do you know? I don't understand why you think that this is so absurd for me to make such a posit such a statement. Why it's not possible that a few people control the stock market? What do you think? It's a fair trade? It's like trading with China. There's no such thing as fair trade anywhere in the world. Everything's rigged. Let's pray to God that this doesn't result in a crash. I read the details, by the way, of what Greece is demanding in order to not. It's unbelievable. They're not willing to give up anything. Nothing. The Greeks don't have an export product to speak of. They produce nothing. They're lazy. They live on welfare. You know, it's not the Greece of Plato anymore. Let's put it to you that way. Greece may have been the cradle of Western civilization, but that was quite a long time ago. And I would say let them exit the EU and let them live on their drachma, whatever they call it, and they go back to the old ways of living. And that's all. They'll have to live on less. There won't be vacations in Paris. Let's go to michaelsavage.com. I invite you to call the show at 855-407-2822. I know you're sitting there you're waiting for me to say something shocking. If you go to my website, michaelsavage.com, on the top right, I'm going to read my headlines. You'll see a picture of a lunatic, the whacked-up liberal sheriff who released illegal alien who killed San Francisco woman. There he is wearing his Captain Queeg outfit. I just love when he puts on the uniform. He looks dumber than he does in a business suit. This jerk, the sheriff, Mirkrami, whatever, pardon me if I can't pronounce his name correctly. Here's a guy beats up his wife, time served, gets it expunged, and runs for sheriff and wins only in San Francisco, the most corrupt city in America. By the way, did you see the follow-up on that story? No one's talking about it. The gun used to kill that woman by the illegal alien from Mexico belonged to a federal agent. Did anyone see that story? Would you raise your hand? The gun that was used to shoot that poor woman in front of her father by the illegal alien belonged to a federal agent. Now, that's a ripe story. Gun allegedly used by San Francisco shooting suspect. Long to federal agents, source says. The gun used by a Mexican illegal immigrant when he allegedly shot and killed a 32-year-old woman at a San Francisco pier belonged to a federal agent? Now, they're telling us that the gun had been stolen during a car burglary in June. I don't buy it. I don't buy it for three reasons. Do you know anyone who leaves a gun in a car? Have you met anyone who leaves their gun in a car? Who was the federal agent who would leave his private gun in a car without losing his job? That's number one. What do you mean a car burglary in June? My apartment is three blocks away from Pier 14. There is broken glass in the streets every morning in that neighborhood by these vermin, these bums, these homeless vandals. And they break into every car they can break into and steal anything they can find. But I don't believe anyone would leave a gun in a car. Huh? Does anyone believe that story? Because the illegal alien, in a mixture of Spanish and English, said he found the gun wrapped in a shirt while he was sitting on a bench at the pier and smoking a cigarette. And he said the gun was on its own. That was yesterday. He picked it up and it started to fire on its own. I guess KGO television told him to say that, or was it his interpreter? We don't know. By the way, who let that reporter and interpreter in to see this bum before he was indicted? I'd like to know who did that. Was it the sheriff? The same Captain Kangaroo who was saying defiantly he's not going to comply with ICE and deport dangerous men like this? And by the way, where is PETA on this bum from Mexico saying that he was there to shoot sea lions? That is another pile of crap. The pier is too high for sea lions to be seen within reach of the pier, incidentally. That's another lie. What am I, the only one in San Francisco who's not on medication? Where is the media on this? Anyway, the gun belonged to a federal agent. Which federal agent? Which moron federal agent would leave a gun in a car? And by the way, now that we're speaking about the gun used to kill the woman belonged to a federal agent, how did they get so quickly? Normally, forensics takes quite a while. Did they find the gun? I thought the gun wasn't really found. I know that the divers from the SS and the muck. By the way, New York Stock Exchange floor trading has resumed. The gangsters are at it again. The boys who control the world, owls of New York, are doing their trades again. I guess they were able to get the guy who was going to short sell him out and bust him out to come to his senses. They probably went and broke his legs somewhere in Syosset and told him, look, call that trade back or else. So the trading has resumed, and maybe the short seller has been told him out like that or else, you know, the legs will go. I just love everything is made believe, like it's clean and up front. I feel like I'm living in the meltdown of civilization. The only one making sense is me and Donald Trump. Anyway, going back to the gun, how did they find the gun so quickly? And by the way, there's another little fact that I may be the only sane man on earth who remembers all the details that were reported. The young lady who was shot by this illegal alien from Mexico said that they heard a pop, and then she said she didn't feel good. Now they say it's a 40 caliber handgun? Anyone out there own a 40 caliber handgun? 40 caliber handguns don't make a pop. They make a boom. And by the way, if you're shot with a 40 caliber handgun, you kind of die immediately. So I don't believe it. What was she shot with? What was the caliber of the gun that was used to shoot her? If it was a pop, it was a low caliber gun. 22, 25, 30. Maybe you'd hear a pop. And even a 32 makes more than a pop. It makes a boom. I don't believe the whole story. It stinks to high heaven. Something's wrong. It stinks to high heaven. It stinks worse than City Hall does, where Boss Tweed runs the city. Whoever Boss Tweed may be today in San Francisco. Name isn't Tweed, nor do I think he wears Tweed. Here's the next story on michaelsavage.com. Obama to bust minorities into white suburbs is the question mark. Now, of course, he's not going to bust minorities into white suburbs. No, he's going to force minorities into white suburbs to make sure they're no longer white suburbs. See, he's got a lot of work to do in the time he has left. He has a lot of work to do. Greece on edge of catastrophe, that we know. There'll be riots and chaos. What do I care? What, the bums don't want to work? You're going to pull back on their pensions and their benefits and they're going to riot? Let them riot. Let them riot. What do I care what they do in Greece? What does that have to do with me? That's what most people think. If they can't afford it, let them stop spending so much. I mean, how much baklava can the world buy? How much baklava can the world buy? I don't even eat baklava. It's too sweet for me. But let's say you like it. Baklava can be consumed. Baklava and olive oil does not make for an economy. I mean, ouzo, I don't know if anyone drinks it anymore. On the left front page of Michael Savage, there's the best-selling novel, Countdown to Mecca. And you really should take a look at it. Under the threat of a third world war, nothing the mission. It's a great novel. I expect many of you have read it because it sold quite a few. The top streaming talk shows in America, number one, average with a 25 share, Rush Limbaugh, 12 share. Number three, Laura Ingraham with a 6 share. Number five, Glenn Beck with a 5-6. Number six, Sean Hannity. Number seven, Tammy Bruce, George Norrie, Alex Jones, and Howie Carr. And that's the younger audience is listening to the show on the internet. If you've missed them, here are the winning essays in the Savage Scholarship Contest. What does it mean to be an American? Apparently, it was too positive for the conservative websites to cover the story. Next article. Killing sparks push to ban illegal alien havens. No more sanctuary cities? Yeah, sure. How do you think these corrupt Democrat socialist politicians got in power and stay in power? Through sanctuary cities. They vote them in, that's all. Next, Vanity Fair, French Jews asking if it's time to leave. You see, France had an open door policy. They had asylum for Muslims. And they brought them all in. And their wonderful, friendly Muslim cousins from Pakistan and around the Middle East. And now French Jews are being driven out of France. And the French are hiding in their coffee as the Muslims riot and pillage. Almost at will in France. Some tried to warn them what was coming, but no one listened. Just to warn you what's coming here, but no one listens. Michael Savage says to you, the phone number is 855-407-282. We're going to run open mic to Mike today, trying to get away from the hard news, but you can see there's too much hard news to get away from. It's too hard to get away from the hard news. I have a special treat for you, by the way, on the show. Those of you who are oriented towards God and religion, which is I would say a part longer than recently. Recently, I moved away from God. You know that. In the past, I was more God oriented, and then I moved away from God. It's not like I didn't believe. It's just like I didn't want to talk about it. Remember, I told you that during my vacation, I had I went into mysticism. I was reading more about it. And the Kabbalah and all of that. I don't want to even say Kabbalah because it was polluted. The word was polluted by the pop star, you know, the fakers. I just say mysticism. It's been a part of my life ever since. Boy, I have a mystical sense of the universe. And I explained to you that I saw a mystical relationship between the gay marriage vote here by the Supreme Court at the same time, that an ISIS follower in North Africa executed vacationers with a machine gun on a beach, and Obama said nothing. I said it's the hand of God because God works in strange ways. So remember, I got into that, right? I got into the mysticism thing, and I told you I was going to be meeting with a mystical rabbi last night at a secret location. Well, for those of you who are interested in such things, I have a of the meeting between myself and three rabbis last night on this very issue of what is mysticism and where is God, perplexing times. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7278-SAVAGE.
My Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. It's the only company I trust to protect my wealth. Call 800-BUY-COIN. Nice if this was simple all over again. It isn't this simple anymore. The vermin of Hollywood would have you believe that it's all about drugs and sex. A lot of good it does them, spitting on donuts and in shops. You see that story? Oh, my God. What's going on? Most of you don't know the references. I'm talking to myself. I read too much news. That's the problem. Some idiot from MTV went in a bakery with a boyfriend. She was caught on television spitting on a donut. I don't understand these people. And then saying, I hate America, so they dropped her from something. State TV, Greek banks closed for a week. I guess they go back to sleeping and eating the donuts there. I have nothing against the Greeks. I mean, they're nice people. I don't know a Greek. I never met a... No, I did meet a Greek once at a festival. He came up to me and he said, Mike, I love your show. Why are you so hard on the Greeks? I said, hard on the Greeks. It's a lazy country. It doesn't produce anything. Don't you understand how the world works? There are productive countries who are very hard work with hardworking people, as America used to be before Obama destroyed it. And so the hard workers in countries keep the whole country going. The leeches are the ones who live off the fat of the land, in plain English. Greece, unfortunately, is not a highly productive nation. It's not that they couldn't be, but they aren't. They don't fundamentally have a great industrial base. Is there a Greek car called the Souvlaki that could compete on the world stage? If the Greeks produced the car, what would it be called? What would you call it? The baklava? You would try to start it and it wouldn't. I don't know. Well, you can make jokes about a Greek car, what it would be. The country's in such turmoil. Now the market doesn't run. United Airlines shuts down. You're telling me China had nothing to do with it? China's heading towards a 1929 market crash. They stopped the plunge of the market by controlling their markets in ways that are totally illegal in America. They have no rules in the stock market in China. So the government goes and buys stocks and prevents people from selling stocks? Wow. Now, Trump's the only one out there, by the way. You know, with all of this turmoil, he's the only one who could win. And I'm going to tell you something else. He'll win the vote of the poor and the vote of the Hispanics. You know why? Because most of the Hispanics who come here are very hardworking. That's a fact of reality. Let's not mince words. And what they earn, they want to hold on to. You think they want a wacko leftist to run the country? They're going to choose a businessman who made a fortune because they understand he might preserve what they've worked for faster than a woman who can't fit into her pumps. That picture of her feet, my God. I know many of you want me to get to the religious part already. I'm not ready for it. I have to move into it psychologically for myself, and I'm not ready for it. I might get to it this hour. I might not. I might get to it next hour. I promise you this. I will play it in the next hour. I don't have any guests, thank God. No one that I don't want to talk to, a book I don't want to hear about. You can go crazy. When I have a guest on, my strength goes from me. I should never have a guest on. Maybe Donald Trump. I'll be right back with all the surprises and the calls and the this and the that.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE. Savage.
America is still reeling from the Mexican illegal who shot that poor young lady on the wharf. And I'm getting reports that are really a little bit weird. Like one person emailed me and said he's a Mexican Lee Harvey Oswald taking the rap for an ICE agent. Now, I don't know what to make of that. Why would an ICE agent shoot a tourist, or let's say a person walking on the wall? What's that about? Are they just trying to trigger panic in the population? Are they pushing for gun control? Because right away, the demagogue, Matt Gonzalez, who is the chief so-called public defender, a real extreme whack job leftist who was on the Green Party, a plant of La Raza. Yeah, La Raza gave him an award. He's now speaking out for the murderer, the alleged murderer. And Gonzalez sponsored a ballot measure, Proposition F, in November of 2004, that would have given non-citizens, meaning illegal aliens, the right to vote in local school board elections. I want you to listen to Matt Gonzalez, the public defender who's representing the murderer, on guns in clip two.
Every day in the United States, innocent people die through gun accidents. In contrast to that, I can say that there are numerous studies, and my own experience supports,
you're full of crap,
that immigrants in this country are far less likely to commit acts of violence
than
native-born persons.
Total lie. Total lie. The data is the opposite. He's a liar, a nightmare. What they get away with in this city because there's no press. No press whatsoever. I have the data. It's the exact opposite. In fact, illegal immigrants are far more likely to commit acts of violence than native-born persons. Notice he conveniently lumps immigrants in this country with illegal immigrants. He makes them all one and the same. They're not one and the same. But anyway, put that aside. He's a plant of La Raza, just as Obama is a great supporter of La Raza. I've tried to tell you this for years. No one listens to me, except the millions who listen to me and buy my books. You want to hear the fact or not? Cecilia Munoz, M-U-N-O-Z, a radical socialist leftist, La Raza head, was taken right into the Oval Office by Obama years ago. She has been driving Obama's illegal immigration policies right from inside the White House. So what more do you need to know? What more do you need to know? But the, you know, on the extremist level here, or let's say you want to talk about something nutty, someone says to me he's a Mexican Lee Harvey Oswald taking the rap for an ICE agent. That's a juicy topic for a novel. If I were to do number four in the series of the Jack Hatfield series, the next one after Countdown to Mecca, which I said I wouldn't do, that's a good way to start the book. Innocent woman walking on the streets, shot by someone, some stoner Mexican guy. They put him, know what to say, kicked the gun, it went off, boom, 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 and made bang, bang, bang. And the next thing you know, all of a sudden, they're attacking guns in San Francisco. Well, I'm all for seizing guns of all of the people who shouldn't have them. Oh, yeah, why don't you have a raid of everyone in the city who's a member of a gang and take their guns away? Start with the illegal aliens and their guns. Start with the gangs and their guns. And end with the gangs and their guns. That's the kind of gun control we need, Matt Gonzalez. But I don't think that's going to happen. Not in this crazy city, this backwards city that the whole country's laughing at. I don't know what is going to happen. You know what's going to happen now. It's all about guns now. It's not about illegal aliens. That's what they're doing. They're trying to change the argument. 855-407-282. Even Hillary chimed in on the sanctuary cities idea. And you could see where she stands in clip number three.
What should be done is any city should listen to the Department of Homeland Security, which, as I understand it, urged them to deport this man again after he got out of prison another time. You know, here's a case where we've deported, we've deported, we've deported. He ends back up in our country. And I think the city made a mistake.
So now the city is being attacked by the feds. The feds are attacking the city. The city's attacking the feds. An innocent woman is dead. Let's go for some callers on the Savage Nation. Let's begin in San Francisco on KSFO Line 2. Go ahead, please. What's your topic?
Hi. Well, you kind of stole my thunder. I was going to ask you if you thought China was behind this cyber attack today, which they're calling a computer glitch, which they said in 2008. And then they hit the Wall Street Journal and also United Airlines, which grounded.
Yeah, it could be China. Why? I think it's China. Hitting us, or it could be the people who control the stock. Remember, not all stock exchanges were turned off. It was only the NYSE, right? NASDAQ was running all day. Well, so I think you have to look at, you have to look at where large China stocks are traded, and I think you'll find most of them on the New York Stock Exchange, which would explain perhaps that they were trying to stop the free fall of their stock market. Wouldn't that make sense to you?
Well, yeah, it hasn't really been reported very much that China has been in a slow free fall the last 3 weeks. Their stock market, they've lost $3 trillion, something like that.
Right, because it was all based on a house of cards. It was bound to fall.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, how long can it go on? They never had their 1929, you know, the equivalent of our 1929. I mean, they're long overdue for it. It's a hyperinflated economy to begin with. The really worrying financial crisis is happening in China, not Greece. And the Telegraph UK reported that China looks like it's heading for its version of the 1929 stock market crash. So I would say it's rational to believe that the communist Chinese manipulated our market by controlling the free fall by turning it off.
I hope they're not going to immediately want to collect on the debt.
That's the problem. What if they call their notes on the U.S. market? What would happen if they demanded payment, an immediate payment? I mean, they're supporting our economy right here. Look, the parallels with 1929 are uncanny. After more than a decade of frantic growth, extraordinary wealth creation in China, and by the way, excess, both economies, America in 29 and China today, are at roughly similar stages of economic development. But they're booms, and they're explained by extremely rapid credit growth. And by the way, China's credit boom dwarfs that of even the Roaring Twenties. They're living on borrowed money, margin investing, and borrowed money and margin investing played a major role in both these outbreaks of speculative excess. So the Chinese stock market bubble could even exceed that of America in 1929.
And if we say
we all know that China's stocks do not represent fair value. Would you agree with me that stocks based on Chinese companies do not represent fair value? It sounds like you know something more about this, right?
Well, no, I just read things. But I, you know, they're corrupt like any other country. But I would think that if we say we cannot pay your debts because it would cause an enormous crash here, they would say that's an act of war. And we know how they've been building up the military and how Obama's been weakening our military. So we're in a real pickle.
Yep. And, of course, since they can penetrate the Defense Department's computers at will, they could probably stop our aircraft carriers at sea. They could probably make our airplanes fall out of the sky, given that they make some of the chips put into our fighter jets, thanks to the Clintons. My friend, we live in perplexing times. Let me send you a gift called Countdown to Mecca, my latest novel, because if you think things are bad, you're right. But I predict they're going to get a lot worse. Now let's go to the next caller. WABC in New York City, line number 3, you're on the Savage Nation. What's on your mind?
Well, anyone would have to figure this was rigged exactly as you say. And it's just like the voting.
Oh, it's you again. You're a pet. I can't take that guy's voice. There's a guy who changes his name every day. Every day he's another name. Harvey, he's Hank, he's Bob, he's Bill. And he gets on. I don't know how he gets through the screeners. I guess he's got a trick voice. Like a Moog synthesizer in his basement. Probably lives with his mother in a basement somewhere in Poughkeepsie. And he synthesizes his voice. And he's on every radio show under another name. There's another guy like this, Bill, on WML in Washington. Every day, the same thing. I'm sure he's a nice guy. But, you know, he has nothing to do. He's another retired white guy with nothing to do. So he calls radio shows. He pirates in. Maybe he could be a fill-in. I'm sorry we hung up on him. Get his number. Maybe we can make him a fill-in. He's got a nice voice. And he likes to talk. He likes to listen to himself. He'd be perfect. WMAL, line 5. I hope it's not Bill. Who's calling, please?
Yes, hello. How are you? This is David. I'm calling.
Oh, thank God you're not Bill. What's on your mind, David?
Calling. I've been a law enforcement officer for 10 years and was just calling for some information. Actually, just to get some points on that 40 caliber handgun. My law enforcement carries, we carry 40 caliber handguns. We've been involved in multiple shootings with those handguns, and we've had shootings involving suspects. We've shot them over 11 times and they haven't necessarily hit the ground dead immediately from that round.
Wait, I'm missing you. You're saying people don't fall down dead from a 40 caliber shot?
It could hit in the right place, but you know, majority of the time, 9 times out of 10, we have a theme that we call with bad guy luck. You can shoot a bad guy 20 times and he won't die instantly from those rounds.
Yeah, but she wasn't a bad guy on drugs. This was a 32-year-old woman walking with her father. This is different than a bad guy on drugs. So, and you know a 40 caliber round is a rather large round, is it not?
Sure, yes, it is.
Yes. I certainly would think that it would kill anyone who was hit in the chest with one shot. And secondly, they said the sound was pop, pop, pop. You know it's not a pop, pop, pop. It's a boom, boom, boom with a 40.
They don't go off accidentally either.
No, absolutely not. Of course an automatic will never, I've never heard of such a thing. It went off, his foot touched it and it went off. Who would buy such a story except San Franciscans, the most naive people in the world?
Absolutely. And I also wanted to touch on just two more things that I had at the time was with the handgun being taken out of the vehicle, which you see more and more with officers doing that along with vests being left in cars. Unfortunately, these days you get officers that are hired here merely for the paycheck and the take-home car that could care less about the job and or their gear. So that does happen. My department, we lose stuff like that all the time with officers.
Right. Now, I got an email from a few people who say it's pretty typical of officers to leave their personal guns in their cars when they go in restaurants. I don't know why. Why do they leave a gun in a car?
9 times out of 10, these officers are extremely foolish. They're young. They're leaving it in there thinking that no one's going to find it.
But why are they leaving their guns in a car? I mean, where are they going where they're not allowed to take it? Aren't they allowed to take it anywhere with them if they're licensed?
Well, I think it sometimes goes into people taking them into bars or they're, you know, going out drinking. You're not supposed to have it on.
All right. I understand that. You're not allowed to carry a gun if you're drinking. You have to lock it in a trunk. Okay, got it. If you have a drink, you have to put it in a trunk. That makes sense. So the illegals, what, break the glass and break into the trunk as well?
Absolutely.
I mean, if you break into a car by breaking the windows, which is very common, and you look at Fisherman's Wharf, I know I'm not supposed to say it because it's not good for business. If you look at Fisherman's Wharf or any of the tourist areas, the streets are lined with broken glass every morning. They're breaking into cars left and right along Fisherman's Wharf, North Beach. They're not doing it in Chinatown because they'd get killed. if they did this in Chinatown. But in the softer areas, they're breaking into cars. But you don't break into a trunk by breaking a window, do you? No. All right. Look, this is too esoteric for the average person. Let's see what the next caller. This is good. The unintended call. I mean, what do you call them? Unscreen calls. Unprotected talk. I forgot what I call my own thing already. These are the topics that we're talking about. People are buzzing about the city, thing. And is he taking a fall for an ICE agent? I just don't know. Why would an ICE agent shoot a civilian? That doesn't make sense. That sounds nuts to me, doesn't it? The Mexican can't speak English, but they coach him to say he found it under the benchy, and it went offy, and it made three soundies. Where did the gun come from so fast? Where did the gun come so fast? How did they find the gun? They found it. The divers found it. In one day, they found the gun already in the muck, and they were able to trace the bullet in one day. I don't buy the story. It's a weird cover story. I don't believe it at all. They got the bullet. The poor woman gets shot. All right, so there's a bullet. In one day, it's released, run through ballistics. Here's another one for you to think about. You ready for this one? Remember Obama and Holder's Fast and Furious, where they exported tens of thousands, I don't know, of guns to Mexico in a crazy idea that they were going to... What was the idea there? How do we know that this is not one of those guns? Because every one of those guns in Fast and Furious that Obama sent to Mexico under Eric Holder were registered, and we all know that... I mean, excuse me, there's a directory of those guns. Could this be one of those Fast and Furious guns that's come back to haunt us and kill an innocent woman and is being covered up? I don't know. But these are questions that only a legitimate government could answer. So I end my inquisition at that point. We don't have a legitimate government. There is not one agency of this government that anyone trusts to tell the truth. What else can I say about it? What else can I say? We're never going to get the answer. But you should know that the New York Stock Exchange is functioning normally, and the criminals are now back at work. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
The Savage Nation is sponsored by Swiss America, the only company I trust with my financial future. Call 800-289-2646 or SwissAmerica.com.
If you're trying to die away.
It is the Savage Nation. Why is old rock and roll so popular even to this day? It's simple. Because there are universal truths in all man, race aside, sex aside, country of origin aside. All of us are as fearful of pain and death and as hungry for love and joy as the other. Did you hear that? I'll say it again. All of us, no matter who we are, I know your heart stopped when I said it because you were looking to leap on me if you were one of my antagonists. But I just made your heart stop because all of us, no matter what our race, our religion, our background, we're all united in our fear of pain and death and just as hungry for love and joy as the other. That's what unites us. Meaning... could you stop the music? I can't even hear myself think. They can't hear me. Yeah, make it lower. In other words, there's a universal element to all of us. And that's what unites us, and that's what brings you to the Savage Nation. Even if you disagree with me politically, you know that philosophically, I can lead you out of the perplexity in which you're living.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE. 855-400-7282. Savage. Warning, the Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, the Savage Nation, home of unprotected talk, borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
Step right up. Don't worry about a thing. Everything's fine. President Obama's been advised. and he says, fly United, take a stroll in San Francisco, eat Greek food, and move your savings into the New York Stock Exchange. Everything's fine. Nothing to see here. Move along. Fly United, eat Greek food, take a stroll in San Francisco, and move all of your savings into the New York Stock Exchange. Move along. The Department of Homeland Security's in charge. The FBI's on top of it. Nothing to worry about. Move along. I don't know about you, but I need a break from the sewer of news out there. I know news is the lifeblood of the talk radio business. I can't take the sewer anymore. I can't swim in the sewer pipe with everyone else. I can't swim in the sewer pipe anymore. You know, I can only do it for so long. And I want to move into some other areas. I really do. I mean, I've done the news in the first hour. I did it open mic. We talked about the New York Stock Exchange. It's such a crock. I don't believe a word any of them say. Yeah, United shut itself down. The stock exchange shut itself down. It was a technical glitch. That's what the news is reporting. Fox News. Technical glitch. Tech glitch. Move along. Oh, now I can eat my souvlaki and walk on the waterfront again. Book some tickets to Disneyland. Yeah, I think I'll take my money out of gold and put it into the New York Stock Exchange because we know that the bankers are so trustworthy. Right. My mind is somewhere else. You can see that. You know, my head is somewhere else. You can feel it. Those of you who have listened to me all these years, you get the vibe off my head, right, through my voice, my magical voice. Man is magical, woman mystical. My head is somewhere else, I'm telling you. So what I'm going to do is take a few calls, and I'm going to go into something that I did last night. At the risk of having half of my, I wouldn't even say half, I would say most of my audience turning the show off. And the faithful, those who believe in God, saying, I cannot believe he's playing this. At the risk of blowing off the unfaithful, the secularists who don't believe in God or hate God, I'm going to do it a little later. You can go put on your mental wigs and your eyeshadow and leave me if you want. And go feed on the sewer pipe of news. I've done it. I'm going to move into something else. Because the fact is, as I said in the last hour, the more I delve into this area that I've been talking about or hinting at, the more I realize that man is closer to his worst enemy than he might think. All of us fear pain and death, no matter what they may say. I'm not talking about the inbreeds that the fanatical ISIS members use. I'm not talking about the inbreeds, those who marry their first cousin and an inbreed without a brain, the ones who put on the suicide vests. I would say 99.999% of mankind are universally afraid of pain and afraid of death, or fear it. And we're all as hungry for love and joy as the other. There are extremes, we know that. So what am I trying to say? I'll have you figure out what I'm trying to say. You can think about what I'm trying to say. I have a goal and a mission for the years I have left in radio, the months I have left in radio, the days I have left in radio, the minutes I have left in radio. Whatever God wants me to, how long he wants me to remain on radio, I have a goal and a mission. I'm not going to swim in the sewer pipe of news day in and day out. I did that. You know, my whole show was not built on news. If you go back to when I began in 1994, the thing that distinguished me was, A, the brutal honesty, number one, the delivery, number two, and the fact that I would get away from the news as often as I would dwell on the news. I would do other things. I don't know what's happened to the talk radio business, but how much can you take of the 2016 election? We're living in the here and now. Do you think the average person cares about the election? They don't. They care about ISIS more than they care about the election. They know that the threat to our national security has never been greater. They know that. That's what the average person wants to talk about. And I've done that. It's why I wrote my novel Countdown to Mecca. Now, admittedly, it wasn't the 20 million copy bestseller, because there was no promotion, and those who love my work have read it or will read it, and that's enough for me. I can't control whether you buy a book of mine, nor do I hope to spend the rest of my life selling you books. What I want to do instead is lift up the curtain of my inner mind, my inner soul, because I want you to understand that when I tell you something about myself, it's true. It's as simple as that. I don't have to talk about anyone else. I don't have to ask you what you think of me. I'm trying to tell you that those of you who are loyalists to this program have to have the faith that what I am saying to you is truthful. So if I said to you that during my vacation, I was dwelling in another, on another plane, and I was thinking on another plane, and I saw things in another way, and I saw God's hand everywhere. You'll have to say, hey, is that theatrical, or does he really believe it? Does this guy really believe what he's saying? How do we really know? How? Because yesterday I told you that in the third hour, I had more energy than I've had in years, or months, let's say. I felt a surge of energy running through me. And where'd the energy come from? I told you it was because after the show, I was going to meet with a mystical rabbi. And I wanted to find out what he knew about the other world, if he knew about it or that other world. And I learned certain things, and he learned certain things. That's the interesting part. And I want to play a little bit of that of that private conversation that I had last night on a mountaintop somewhere outside of San Francisco, in a quiet location where we can listen to the birds and watch the leaves move and see the butterflies and such. You can see the hair move on a dog. You could actually hear the hair move on a dog. It was so quiet. But in the midst of this, there was humanity. And I dwelled in that world. And I'm going to go to it soon. I'm not going to... You want me to do it now, Robert? Is this a good time to begin it? Why don't we begin that conversation now? And if I like it, we'll play all of it. If not, we'll move on to the sewer pipe of the news. Let's play it, Robert. Just go for it.
Hey,
if you can play it.
And you asked if there's... If I knew a mystic, someone that's a mystic.
Right.
And we spoke about the idea of mystics is how the... How... The voice of Hashem speaks through Michael Savage on the radio.
Does it? I said, I didn't. I would say God does. I said, does he?
Yeah, he does.
I hope so.
He does. He does do that.
I hope he gives me strength from day to day because some days I don't think I want to do it anymore.
He does do that.
You got to do it.
Some days I don't want to go on. I want to retire. I want to go in another direction. It's 21 years. It's a long time. It's a day and it's 21 years at the same time. It started yesterday. But I'm tired sometimes. It's enormous pressure on me to every minute worrying about what I'm saying and worry about the world's horrors. Yeah. To take it in, you know, it has its effects.
How can someone that has to be on and connected to the source and making sure that the source is being channeled through him, how does he tap in? How is he able to transmit that to all of us, to the world, to the people?
I'll tell you what I do sometimes when I remember to do it. A few minutes before the show or right before as the sound is starting and the whole thing's starting, I hear it, you know, with the speaker playing. I will say, God, give me the strength. God, please give me the strength to do the right thing, to not make a schmuck of myself, and to lead people in the right direction. That's all I say.
That's wonderful.
That's all I say sometimes.
Like all the great kings, King David, and all the great kings before they went to war, they would pray, God, please are
stop right. It. What do you, get over here. No. No.
They would all pray, God, let us be successful in war. And God is listening to you, Michael.
I hope so.
There's no question.
He lets me go astray too.
He lets you go astray and come back. But there's a purpose. We all have it. And God gave you your purpose.
He lets me shmadre astray.
Absolutely. And then we make circles. That's what life's about. But this simple, your simple prayer to God before the show is worth everything in the world.
Then I think I have to do this every day, not occasionally.
Right.
I think this is important to do every day. Not just whenever it occurs to me. This is a must. It's like brushing your teeth or washing your face.
All right, so that was a little bit of the conversation. Just if you want to know what it was. The first voice you heard was Rabbi Joseph Langer of San Francisco. And then it was Rabbi Mendy Cohen from Sacramento, Chabad of Sacramento. And then, of course, it was yours truly, Michael Savage. Now, why am I playing this for you? I just want to, that's all. I'm not trying to sell you anything. There's no secret to... reason for it. I'm now not going to launch into my latest book on mysticism. I'm not selling you anything. I'm just trying to tell you that there's a reason for this radio show that is beyond what you may think. There are many stumbling blocks that were put in my way from the day I began in radio. People try to stop me. In San Francisco, I was on KSFO. From the first day, I was tripped up. And people tried to stop me. They stood in my way every step of the way. And then along the way, there was a lawsuit that went on for years that almost destroyed me. But I destroyed them with God's help. They were destroyed. They're out of business fundamentally. And that was a time that the show could have ended. I left radio, as you know, for a month. There were no opportunities for me. And out of the blue, I was God parted the Red Seas for me. And I wound up where I am today, for better or for worse. So there's always more to things in your life than meet the eye. There are always spiritual dimensions. Some of us are aware of them and some aren't. And some of us understand that being on the radio is an honor and a responsibility. And I try my best to live up to that responsibility, but sometimes the burden becomes too strong and I have to take a breather. And I just wanted to tell you that. It's that simple. Now, where am I going with this? I don't know. I'm not going anywhere with it. Nowhere. But as long as you're listening to the show, I have an obligation to you, and I can't bore you, number one. The first rule of radio is I don't want to bore you, or you're not going to listen to me. If you're bored, you're not going to listen. And I'm not going to just hammer the news day in and day out. The news is so horrible. It's so extraordinarily negative. The pollution of the news is so negative. The murders, the destruction of our nation by the president, his willingness not to look the other way, but to actively destroy every decent institution in the country and get away with it because of the weaklings and the fellow travelers and the media is overwhelming. But if I'm to believe what I just said to you, that God's hand is everywhere, I would have to ask you, why would he have permitted this charlatan Obama to have become president twice? And what does God intend for America to watch and witness the downfall of the Statue of Liberty in front of the world? Why would he want this? Now, those of you who are religious would say it's punishment because we turned away from God. I get that. I don't think it's as simple as that. I think that there's a deeper answer and a fundamental answer that we haven't yet come to. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
Hey, our Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. The only company I trust for wealth insurance, gold and silver. Call 800-BUYCOIN. All right, so where do you want me to go? You want to swim in the sewer pipe of news with me, or you want to go spiritual, mystical, magical, nutrition, health? I mean, there's a, you can go anywhere you want. It's a talk show. When I began to talk radio, the good shows would do a photography segment, a car segment, a news segment, but it wasn't 3 hours of hocking people's brains to death with news. You could say, well, things are worse now. They are. But that's not what you need to hear for 3 hours. I think that for this country to survive and come out of the hellhole that Obama has drove us into, and he's not finished yet, he's only starting, I think that the people who really believe in the country and in God need to elevate their spirits to counter this evil. I think that may be part of the mission of the show. I need to help you lift your own spirits up because they've been beaten down with what the Supreme Court did to this country in the last few weeks alone is enough to take a strong man and make him weep. To believe that these people would do this to this country. There's a war against Christianity in particular. There's certainly war against religion in general. The atheists are in charge at every turn. The anti-Americanism is at an all-time high. And so people don't know which way to turn. I think they have to turn within. That's what I'm trying to get at. Let me take a call and see where you want to go with the show. WBAP in Dallas, Texas. Welcome to the Savage Nation. What's on your mind?
Yes, this is Tony. God wants us to become better. And that does not happen if he just fixes everything for us. When you look at the prodigal son story, that story is mostly about...
All right, wait, please. Let's not go into the Bible now. I think we'd rather stay focused on the show and what I said. Do you want us to go into that more of the spiritual area? Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
So you weren't offended by me playing that secret little meeting?
Of course not. That's on the same point, and you know.
No, I'm not trying to cut you off, Tony. What I'm trying to ask is, did you find it interesting, or did you find it disturbing or boring?
I found it very interesting.
Because the religious people would find it interesting.
Yes.
Because they know that when I say to you that I'm actually going to meet with someone to get into the spiritual elements of my own life, I was not making it up.
Well, you have to clarify what type of religious person you're talking about.
I'm talking about Jewish rabbis who are very into mysticism.
Well, whether you're talking about a legalistic person or somebody that's interested in the bigger picture and can read.
Well, they're interested in the bigger picture, not in the legalistic. They're not Reform. They're not Reform Jews. No, they're not the Woody Allen type of Jew. No, they're not the Bagel and Lox Jew. They're not the J Street Jew who is a Jews in name only. I mean, we hear about rhinos. Have you heard of gynos, Jews in name only?
Yes.
I made it up. Gynos, Jews in name only. That would be the Woody Allen Jews. The Hollywood Jews. Am I allowed to use those two words together in one sentence? I think that's illegal. Hollywood, you can't say it. The Jews don't run Hollywood, no, not at all. Katzenberg, no. Geffen, no. Can't say it. I mean, the atheism is beyond belief. They're not Jews, they're atheists. They don't believe in God, generally. But it's not about bashing. I don't want to use this to symbolically bash anybody. I'd like to lift it up rather than bring it down. So I'd rather do news. You want me to do news, mysticism, magical tricks? You want me to get out a top hat and a cane, do card tricks? I can only do the news up to a point. I'm bored of the news. It's horrible. Yeah, right, I know. The stock market, yeah, stopped because of a technical glitch. The illegal aliens, gun went off by itself. Obama is the most honorable American in the history of the country, and he has only the best interest of the nation at heart. I get it, yeah. Illegal aliens all come here to work, right?
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
So, what shall the epitaph be? Here lies the man who sold the most books. Here lies the man who had the highest ratings in radio for 3 years in a row. Here lies the—I mean, what are people doing in the media to begin with? What are they doing? Just stirring up hatred and anger to increase ratings? I mean, well, there's a lot of hatred out there, and a lot of reason to be angry. I get it, but is that our job to just stir you up and get you pissed off when you're already pissed off to begin with? To point out how these gangsters have taken over every city? How they're ripping off the treasury, robbing us. I mean, yeah, it's out there, but I don't think that's my only job. You know, whether it's the outrage of that woman being shot in San Francisco and the cover story being a big lie from top to bottom, it stinks to high heaven. An ICE agent's gun was used by an illegal alien, which went off by itself. Nobody, Disney couldn't produce a cartoon that would be believable if that was the script. An 8-year-old wouldn't follow that script. Where are they coming up with this garbage? Yeah, the stock market stopped for 4 hours because of a tech glitch. Okay, that's another Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse. I could do it day in and day. I've done it for 21 years. I want to move into something else. I want to move into another part of my being, your being, his being. We're being, we're all being conned, all aboard. WMAL in Washington, line 6. Go ahead, you're on the Savage Nation. What's on your mind?
Michael, it's a pleasure and an honor to talk to you. I, for full disclosure, I told your call screener I'm a rabbi, not a Chabad rabbi, but an Orthodox rabbi. But I want to say to you that going into the spiritual topics is what part of what makes you such a wonderful and unique host, because you're hilarious when you talk about the tragedies in this country. Unfortunately, I mean, hilarious at the same time as biting and incisive, but you reflect the whole picture of what a person should be thinking about in this world, like you said, not just news 100%, not just, it's beautiful. I mean, I think probably it would be boring if you did spirituality every single minute, but it's a beautiful
thing. I couldn't do it, right. See, that wouldn't be me either, because then I'd be the preachy guy. I can't do that. That's not me either. But underneath this comedic, political show, there is a deep spiritual driving force is what I'm getting at. So what am I looking for, to burnish my halo? I don't think that's it. I think I'm trying to move the listeners into a slightly different area of their own mind, because we're all dwelling in the sewer pipe of news. CNN, Fox News, I mean, they're driving us from the sewer pipe. I don't care how clean their dresses are. It's the sewer pipe that's running it all, isn't it?
Totally true. it's totally true. And without trying to compete with the rabbis you were speaking with, of course, but I could give you one insight, which maybe they talked to you about why, you know, why we're going through the darkest period probably ever, if I could just say it. And I'm sure you've thought of this, but it's a classic idea, certainly in Judaism, but that, you know, before the revelation of a great light comes a time of most darkness. I mean, you see it in the Exodus from Egypt and the Passover Seder, which people know that that's how it's built, from darkness to light. And, I mean, I don't see anyone, again, whether one's religious or not, just thoughtfully looking at the world, how can someone not say that either we're just going down the tubes, but we don't, people of faith don't believe that, because it's the preparation for a revelation that, by contrast, will be so amazing of true values in the world, of goodness and of kindness and of real kindness, not the false stuff that's peddled around, you know, on the radio, on other radio shows. So that's why, that's my, you know, why I think it's, you know.
Very concisely summarized. Many people believe that. I remain somewhat optimistic, but I remain quite trepidatious about how much time is left for this individual in the White House to do more damage. Every day he goes after another institution of this nation in his distorted, twisted vision of how to remake the country. And they won't stop him. There is no opposition party, and certainly the weaklings in the media are on his side. So, I mean, how do we stop this? How do we stop this man from doing even more harm to the point where it's irrevocable, is the question many of us are asking. We can't simply sit here passively and hope God will step down and save us from him. He is an out-of-control, anti-American leader who is leading us into an abyss from which we may never recover. That is what most people that I know who are intelligent and successful see him doing. So how do you religious people see this turning around?
I mean, the you know, a religious orientation, a faith orientation, certainly from a Jewish point of view and others, is not about being passive and just prayer. Prayer is important, as you beautifully talked about, but doing what you're doing, I mean, everyone in their own way, not everyone has the clout that you do, the audience you do, but, I mean, you can't give up hope. You can't retreat into just prayer. Prayer is important, but just standing up for these values that are human values, and not even, you know.
But why does an evil man like Obama, and I will call him evil, because anyone who goes after the fundamental institutions of America and says that they're bad and wants to transform them, in my book, that's evil. I don't know what else is evil. I don't care whether, what does he have to have, horns on his head for me to see what he's doing? Every day I wake up to another disastrous attack upon the fundamental institutions that made this nation great. And he guises it under the thing of fairness and racism and gets away with it. So I'm asking you, how does this turn around if the people themselves don't even see what's going on?
And Michael, there's one other
I would say maybe 20% of the population knows how evil he really is and the damage he has done. From national security to fiscal policies, wherever you turn, it's an America from which we may never, ever recover. He is changing us into a Frankenstein of a nation. You know, people say that his model is Europe. I don't believe that. I don't think he has a model. I think he just has pure, unadulterated hatred for this country. That's how I see it. And he gets away with it because he's the smoothest actor in the history of the presidency. So what do we, the people, do about it? We voted last November. Look what we got, the drunk Boehner and the backstabbing gobbler McConnell. What's next? How do we save the country if we can't vote bums like him out?
It's horrible. Can I say one quick thing? I appreciate so much you letting me talk. One thing that, I don't know, you might have talked about, I missed it, but one of the things that was so horrible to me was after the Supreme Court vote on the, you know, gay marriage, they did a light show at the White House. You know, he put on the White House side the colors of the gay pride movement.
I said on my show it was the most disgusting hijacking of the White House in my entire life.
Well, I wish I heard.
How could he turn the entire White House into a symbol of a 2% minority in this nation? How is that even possible? How could that be done in a time? But the very same day that he did that, the radical Muslims had one of their psychotic throwback inbreeds go on a beach in Tunisia and execute 50, 100 people with a machine gun. And I said, that's God's hand at work, the two sides of it. I also said that I was on vacation. I tried to find it on Fox News and nobody would cover. They basically would not cover the execution on that Tunisian beach by the Muslim. Did you know that? They wouldn't run it?
Yeah.
They wouldn't show it. They wouldn't show it, yet their ratings are sky high. I don't know how. I don't understand it. I said all of these things. Yes, I said it. I was very bold in my statement that I was personally and deeply offended by this president hijacking the White House for a political minority, such a small political minority at that. And especially when he knew it was an affront to all religious people in the world.
And then it was like a day later he was in Charleston, like, you know, and the press was giving him such a wonderful ratings on his heartfelt sermon there. But, like, he was, like, spitting in religious people by doing that. I mean, if you have that position, okay, fine, that's your position. I disagree with it. But to, like, glorify it, to, like, wallow in, you know, or whatever, it was horrible. It offended me.
I felt the same way. I was stunned by the lowness of this. I saw it for what it was. Another leader would have said, look, okay, they won in the Supreme Court. It's going to offend most religious people. I'm not going to rub their noses in it. Let it be. Leave it alone. But no, he had to rub everyone's nose in it, didn't he? He had to hijack the White House and do what he did, turn it into a homosexual light show. I mean, what should I mince words and say what it wasn't? All right, look, this is what I mean by what's going on in the world, and say, how much more can the people take till they snap? How much more of a broadside against traditions can this country take from the most destructive president that the nation has ever put up with? How much more? And where is the opposition? Where is the opposition? Well, there's a lot of opposition. There's going to be civil disobedience in this country as a result of this outrage. We haven't seen it yet. WBOB. Line number 8, you're on the Savage Nation. What's on your mind?
Just keep doing what you're doing. It's a combination that we need. I was calling in about the guns that were broken into town here in Jacksonville. But after you were talking about your revelation of your speaking to your rabbis, I can just tell you from my own experience, 40 years of my faith has gotten me through. And I think it's just a very good combination. But you started talking about the president. I want to read you a remark by Marx himself wrote. And this was actually written in a...
Wait, a remark by who?
Marx.
Karl Marx?
Yes, Karl Marx.
Go ahead.
It's from a pamphlet that a relative of mine wrote in 1904 about the indictment of socialism. So we've been here before. But in this pamphlet of 32 pages, one of the things he wrote, Marx himself wrote, man makes religion, not religion man. The abolishment of religion as the deceptive happiness of the people is a necessary condition for their true happiness. And I think that is Obama.
Absolutely. He's a stone-hearted Marxist. He always has been. He was raised by those who felt religion was the opiate of the masses. And he is obviously trying to change that from religion being the opiate of the masses to government being the opiate of the masses. There's no question about it. That's exactly what he stands for. He's a disciple of Lenin or Marx. Only he does it in such a smooth way that the people don't even see it. They're busy watching another slut in Hollywood spit on a donut in a donut shop. Okay, well, look, we'll keep on doing what we're doing. It's that simple. Headlines, invisible danger, SF murder puts spotlight on illegal immigrant crime. Really? There's no illegal immigrant crime. Don't they all come here to work? Well, the sheriff doesn't think that they all come here to commit crime. He says they all come here to work. Now let's go to the issue, the false issue. We're going to have to swallow this one soon. The communist pope. Again, I can't mince words because here I am defending religion and strongly disagreeing with this pope, because this pope is not really a religious figure. He is a Marxist political operative, in my estimation. He's pushing this whole notion of global warming when even one of the leading Nobel laureates who once advised Obama says that Obama is dead wrong. Listen to clips 8 and 9.
Global warming is really a hot topic. And what I said then, and which I still believe, is that global warming really has become a new religion, because you can't discuss it. So here is a statement by Obama. He gave a recent speech at the college in the United States, And he said, no challenge poses a greater threat to future generation than climate change. That's what he said. That's a ridiculous statement. See, United States probably kills maybe a few hundred people a day. They probably killed a million or several million people the last 10 years or so. We've been at war. And the biggest problem Obama faces is climate change? How can he say that?
Now, that's Nobel laureate Dr. Ivar Givar says Obama's dead wrong. And he gives the statistic, the data, rather, on global warming. Most scientists know it's a big lie. And the scientist I had on last week confirmed the big lie and said that it's all about a power grab and a money grab. And the reason I'm bringing it up is because this false prophet, the Pope, will be in America soon. And shockingly, he's going to give a speech before Congress in which he will promote the great big lie and the power grab of this global warming nonsense. So we have bigger issues than we may think. Here's another big issue. In the midst of the gay marriage ruling and the Obamacare ruling, the Supreme Court did something perhaps even more immediate and worse. They said that the housing rule could be used to regulate and diversify neighborhoods, whatever the Housing Act was. HUD now has unveiled regulations to diversify neighborhoods. That is the equivalent of school busing. Do you remember what school busing did to America's schools? That's what Obama now wants to do to white suburbs. It's that clear. Pay attention, my friends, because if you think you're going to get away scot-free, I think you're mistaken. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
Your Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. It's the only company I trust for tangible assets, gold and silver. Call 800-BUY-COIN. Welcome back to the Savage Nation, 54 minutes after the hour. I got some good sound for you here. If you want to join the program, it's 855-400-7282. Let us see. Let's begin with Jimmy Carter saying Jesus would support gay marriage. I don't know how he knows that. I know that Jimmy Carter and his family, I think that they twirled snakes over their head and drank strychnine as part of their religious practices. And perhaps in one of those whirling dervishes, he saw Jesus and Jesus told him this. But listen to clip 13.
I believe that Jesus would approve gay marriage, but I'm not, that's just my own personal belief.
Yes. Yeah.
I think Jesus would encourage any sort of love affair if it was honest and sincere and was not damaging to anyone else. And I don't see that gay marriage damages anyone else.
That is so kind of him, isn't it? It's very kind of him. It's very benevolent. I don't know when he met Jesus. He believes Jesus would... Okay, he said he believes, not that he knows. Thank you. I was worried for a minute. He didn't say, I know Jesus would approve gay marriage. All right. He said, I believe. You could. Maybe he did meet him. I don't know. In one of his snake... He's in a cult, a religious cult, where they drink a certain kind of fluid. I think embalming fluid. And they wave snakes over their head.
Yeah. Join the Savage Nation. Call now. 855-400-SAVAGE. 855-400-7282. Savage. Warning, the Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, the Savage Nation, home of unprotected talk, borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
It is the Savage Nation. While we're still the majority, welcome to the program. Obama's not yet through breaking the egg to make the omelet of Marxism. Welcome to the program again. So what would you like to do in this hour? Let's see. Disney to remove Bill Cosby statue. Can't they leave him alone? Obama urged to revoke Medal of Freedom from Bill Cosby. No one can justify what he may have done, but why is Bill Cosby suddenly the worst person in the world? Isn't there a villain bigger than Bill Cosby that could be picked on? Like, let's say the head of ISIS, who rapes, murders, kidnaps, and slaves. Why is there no petition to destroy him? Why is it Bill Cosby? Why? Because the media is insane. That's why. The media is insane, run by insane people. 855-407-282. Let's go to the calls. I have so many good calls. Here's a listener letter that I never read you. Dr. Savage, I first started listening to you when I was 16 and got my driver's license. I live in the East Bay of San Francisco. That's over in Berkeley, Oakland. And used to drive myself to piano lessons after school. I would leave every day, and halfway through that drive, the Savage Nation came on. Music is the thing I've always loved most of all in my life, and there were times it was difficult to get out of the car and leave you behind to go to the piano. That was in 1997. In 1999, I moved to Ohio to attend Oberlin Conservatory of Music. That first semester was a very dark time until I learned how to listen to the Savage Nation on the computer, because this was before your show went national. I remember when you announced to your then local audience that your show would be going national. I was already listening to you from across the country, but I was one of the few because internet radio was very new, and because the only reason I was lucky enough to have heard of you was because I was from the Bay Area. As I discovered philosophy, my days were filled with wonder. But if you know anything about Oberlin, they were filled with despair. You got me through some hard times dealing with the scum of the earth at Oberlin. Your show literally gave me strength. God, I remember so happily that time you put some rancid, rabid feminist in her place. I forget the prominent author's name. I forget the topic. I don't even remember which one of you hung up on the other, but I can still hear her outraged voice as you told it like it was. There was also some vile Ivy League professor, I vaguely recall. All I remember now was the experience of my reaction. Not my negative reaction to him so much, but my overwhelming emotional reaction to you, Savage, or rather to your brilliant analysis of his lies, his motives, his entire psychology. I used to fantasize about writing you fan letters and having dinner with you at one of the restaurants in San Francisco. Of course, I never did. I wasn't delusional. Why would you be interested in some college fan who, for all you knew, was a psychopath killer? But I did call you a lot. And on and on. Very good. Let's see what I want to read. I remember your favorite books. I called about Ayn Rand, blah, blah, blah. There was some stream of consciousness poetry slams that were spectacular. I remember Dr. Unsavage, your book recommendations. I'll always remember Lin Yutang's If I'm Not For Me, Who Will Be? Your matchmaking, The Heart is a Lonely Hunter special, stories from your childhood in New York, where I knew I was headed, of your brother, a family antique shop, your father's hosting style, Mom Savage's secret to longevity, and believe me, I can go on and on and on. It's been years and years since I've called your show. I'm not entirely sure what made me write today, though I've sort of been meaning to for a long time. Part of it was your mentioning your scholarship winners. I wrote a lengthy opinion, and he goes on, he loved the scholarship winners, of whom there are five, and you want to read their essays, they're on michaelsavage.com. He ends with this. I'm now 34 years of age. A couple of hours ago on the air, you were talking about your scholarship, and you used the phrase giving back. That really bothered me, because the implication is that you took something away and that there is some debt that you must equalize. Michael, you don't owe us anything. You've given us so much. That's the experience that you should remember when reflecting on your show, Michael Savage. With admiration, appreciation, and fondness, I can't read his name because I don't know if he wants me to. It may get him in trouble in this new fascist liberal America, where anyone who loves the country and loves America is now a suspect. Anyone who breaks through into our country and sucks the system dry as a hero to the communist regime. It's your show. Let's go where you want to go. 855-407-282. Here's Donald Trump in 12. No, here's Giuliani defending Trump in clip 12. Let's hear what Rudy has to say.
I don't agree with Donald's comment. As I said, I would say it totally differently. But I think they're overdoing
right
it.
And I'm not taking. No, I don't want to hear him. If you start by saying I don't agree with his comment and then you say you agree with him, that means you're trying to have it both ways. Either you support Trump or you don't. Don't say you don't agree with his comment. His comment was clear. He didn't say all Mexicans are criminals. That was a distortion of the vermin in the media. All the guys who suddenly grew a beard and got glasses to make themselves look intellectual. Jake Tapper. A real intellectual they found somewhere with that other one. Chuck Todd. Chuck Todd, another great intellectual giant. Then we have other song. I don't know if I want to play the other song. I'm in a weird mood. I told you I'm in a weird mood. I'm spacey today. I'm like spaced out. You know what I'm afraid of? I think that getting into the mysticism has like warped my mind. Maybe I shouldn't have done it. Maybe I was better off staying in the two dimensions that I live in. Now, I don't want to be in the third dimension. I feel a part of me is in another dimension. I don't want to be there. Robert, I need to pull my soul back down from the heavens. All right, God, listen to me. Thank you very much for what you've given me, but let me have my soul back. You know, there's mind, body, spirit, right? And any tradition, whether it be in India with the gurus, or Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, Islam for that matter, authentic Islam, tries to unify mind, body, and spirit. You know that. That's a pretty big balancing act to get all of them in sync, mind, body, spirit. That's like tuning in an early color television set when you had the red and the green and the blue colors that you had to control. Remember that, Robert? Red, green, and blue colors, and you had to kind of make the color right in the early days of color television. That's the mind, body, and spirit. You got to get all three of them just right to get the picture clear. That's a good metaphor. I think I'll save that one for when I become a religious figure. Maybe that's what I'm doing, Robert. Maybe I'm making a transition and don't even know it from commercial radio into a religious broadcaster. You know, I don't know whether it would be bigger or smaller. It might be more enjoyable or less enjoyable. I don't know. Maybe I should do... Huh? What should I do? What'd you say, Ron?
I said you are a minister.
I am an ordained minister, right, in that I paid $15 and got the certificate. And now I join Reverend Al Sharpton in the esteemed reverend business. I probably paid more for the reverend's title than he did. It was given to him, reverend. Where is he, by the way? They've kept him, they've dummied him up. They put him on ice because they don't want another city to burn. They put him on the shelf. They won so many things in a row, they figured what they needed the agitator for. All right, it's your show. Let's see where you want to go with it. Let's take a quick caller or two. WJR in Detroit, what's on your mind? What's your name? Go ahead, please.
Hi. This is Kathy
yes.
from Dearborn.
And what's on your mind in Dearborn, Michigan?
All right. There was an article in the Free Press on Sunday about a Fatima Abadabadoo. She wants to take down the statue of Hubbard, Orville Hubbard, a former mayor, because of injustice and for racial... The burden.
Yeah, well, that's what goes on during a revolution. They take down statues. They go around the country, they take down statues. What will she erect in the place of that statue of that individual? A picture of a statue of Obama?
Could be.
A picture of him with a five iron or what?
Why don't they take down the museum that they built or that big mosque they put up for the beheading of the prosecution.
Oh, I see what you mean. That's the equivalent. In other words, why blame this man for something that happened when he had nothing to do with it? I'd be like saying you should blame the mosque for the beheadings in the Middle East. It makes as much sense. I got it. Well, all right. You see, you're a thinking woman out there. I'm sending you a gift copy of Michael Savage's Countdown to Mecca. I'm sure you'll love the read. If not, give it away to Huckleberry Finn. WMAL in Washington, D.C. on line 3. What's on your mind? Go ahead, please.
Yes, sir. This is Jose. I was actually immigrated from Central America. One of the reasons that I immigrated to the United States is because I wanted to get away from communism, socialism. But it seems that the people that started that in Central America are bringing it here and are currently changing states like California, Florida. Look what's happening to the country. Now, it feels like I'm living back in Central America, especially with Obama in the presidency.
All right. Well, him, you know, Obama and de Blasio in New York, they were fans of... what went on in those socialist nations. Meanwhile, a new strain of polio-like virus is leading to paralysis in children. Remember Trump said that they're bringing in diseases? I mean, that's an old story to me. I remember reporting on immigrants and epidemics for a very long time. But a new strain of a polio-like virus may be leading to paralysis in children. You don't want to tell that to anybody because that's an embarrassing fact. That's an inconvenient truth. Life Science reports that more than 100 children in 34 states mysteriously developed muscle weakness or paralysis in their arms or legs. Researchers previously linked a virus called enterovirus D68 with some of the cases. Do you know where enterovirus D68 came from? They came along with Obama's children last summer. Remember all those children that he brought in on the trains? You see, this virus, enterovirus D68, is endemic in Honduras, which is why I, Michael Savage, warned you about it and called it the Honduran flu. And now we see paralysis. Not one word from the CDC, the useless CDC, once a distinguished organization and now filled with politicians with medical degrees and PhDs. So yes, my friends, there are consequences to bad policies. In this case, the outbreak of acute flaccid myelitis, which is affecting children as a result of Obama's importation of unscreened children last summer from Central America. This summer, he has more of them planned. New strain of polio-like virus leading to paralysis in children. Go tell that to the sanctuary city of San Francisco. You see, most of the city fathers and mothers have no children, if you get the drift. So they're not worried about this polio-like virus leading to paralysis in children because they don't have any. And they frankly avoid children. They hate children. They think people who have children are breeders, and they sneer at them. And so this doesn't affect them at all. They know that they're above even this virus, and it won't touch them. Get the picture? Well, I hope you do. It's easy. I'll be back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
My Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com, the only company I trust to protect my wealth with gold and silver. Call 800-BUYCOIN. So let's focus for a few minutes on immigrants and epidemics. As you well know, and perhaps if you're an older person, when your grandfather or father came to America, they had to go through a health screening at Ellis Island. All of you remember the Godfather movie where little Vito Corleone was quarantined because he had a disease. Today, of course, they waved them right in because there is no Ellis Island. In fact, they're put at the front of the line and stuck right into our elementary schools. And many of these children, whether they be from Central America, in the case of the polio-like virus being brought in from them, have somewhat of an immunity to these viruses, while our children have none. And so they're getting very sick. And I reported on it last year. The CDC should have stopped this. They should have reported on it. But there's not a decent man or woman amongst them who will stand up and say enough is enough. He is causing grave harm to the population. Occasionally, you'll see an occasional individual in one of the departments or other saying something about this madman in the White House. So I say is like the German pilot who was locked himself in the cabin and was, you know, basically driving the plane right into a mountaintop. Once in a while, someone will stand up and say he's wrong. You know, someone who's no longer in the government. But by and large, Obama is doing grave harm to this nation with his idiocy, his progressive idiocy. Flooding America with illegal aliens is the topic. We saw the crime in San Francisco as the number one issue. But the bigger issue to me is not only the crime that they're bringing in. How many times have I told you the illegals account for over a third of federal sentences? I've told it to you over and over again. And yet this liar in San Francisco is representing the murderer, Matt Gonzalez, a former member of the Green Party, a nut who tried to get illegals to vote. Public defender Matt Gonzalez attacks guns instead of the illegals who are using them. But I've tried to tell you, there's a fact, there's a data. There's data. Illegal immigrants account for nearly 37% of federal sentences in 2014. This is not, doesn't require a Nobel Prize to understand. Illegal immigrants account for about 3.5% of the population, but they represent 37% of federal sentences. Did you hear this? That's according to U.S. Sentencing Commission data. Now, I want you to listen to what I have to live with here in San Francisco with people who have tried to tar and feather me for telling the truth. Here is public defender Matt Gonzalez, a former member of the Green Party. Here is a public defender who is trying to blame guns for the murder on a murder on the wharf. Listen to O2.
Every day in the United States, innocent people die through gun accidents.
liar.
In contrast to that, I can say that there are numerous studies, and my own experience supports that immigrants in this country are far less likely to commit acts of violence than native-born persons.
All right, now, he received the La Raza Award a few years ago. He's a stooge for the invasion forces from Central and South America. And I'll give you the data that you can put in your pipe and smoke with medical marijuana. While illegal aliens account for about 3.5% of the U.S. population, they represented 36.7% of federal sentences in FY 2014, following criminal convictions, according to U.S. Sentencing Commission data. It's that simple. It's that simple. Illegal immigrants represented 16.8% of drug trafficking, 20% of kidnapping, hostage taking, 74% of drug possession, 12% of money laundering, and 12% of murder convictions. But don't tell that to the gangsters who run San Francisco at the behest of the illegal alien invaders. You are losing your nation. Sanctuary cities are the front lines of the battles. This young lady was just the most prominent of those killed, maimed, robbed, or beaten by one of these sterling immigrants.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE. 855-400-7282.
Savage. Hey, Savage. Let's go to michaelsavage.com. I know you're sitting there you're waiting for me to say something shocking. If you go to my website, michaelsavage.com, on the top right, I'm going to read my headlines. You'll see a picture of a lunatic, the whacked up liberal sheriff who released illegal alien who killed San Francisco woman. There he is wearing his Captain Queeg outfit. I just love when he puts on the uniform. He looks dumber than he does in a business suit. This jerk, the sheriff, Mirkrami, whatever, pardon me if I can't pronounce his name correctly. Here's a guy beats up his wife, time served, gets it expunged, and runs for sheriff and wins only in San Francisco, the most corrupt city in America. By the way, did you see the follow-up on that story? No one's talking about it. The gun used to kill that woman by the illegal alien from Mexico belonged to a federal agent. Did anyone see that story? Will you raise your hand? The gun that was used to shoot that poor woman in front of her father by the illegal alien belonged to a federal agent. Now, that's a ripe story. Gun allegedly used by San Francisco shooting suspect belonged to federal agents, source says. The gun used by a Mexican illegal immigrant when he allegedly shot and killed a 32-year-old woman at a San Francisco pier belonged to a federal agent? Now, they're telling us that the gun had been stolen during a car burglary in June. I don't buy it. I don't buy it for three reasons. Do you know anyone who leaves a gun in a car? Have you met anyone who leaves their gun in a car? Who is the federal agent who would leave his private gun in a car without losing his job? That's number one. What do you mean a car burglary in June? My apartment is three blocks away from Pier 14. There is broken glass in the streets every morning in that neighborhood by these vermin, these bums, these homeless vandals. And they break into every car they can break into and steal anything they can find. But I don't believe anyone would leave a gun in a car. Huh? Does anyone believe that story? Because the illegal alien, in a mixture of Spanish and English, said he found the gun wrapped in a shirt while he was sitting on a bench at the pier and smoking a cigarette. And he said the gun fired on its own. That was yesterday. He picked it up and it started to fire on its own. I guess KGO television told him to say that, or was it his interpreter? We don't know. By the way, who let that reporter and interpreter in to see this bum before he was indicted? I'd like to know who did that. Was it the sheriff? The same Captain Kangaroo? Who is saying defiantly he's not going to comply with ICE and deport dangerous men like this? And by the way, where is PETA on this bum from Mexico saying that he was there to shoot sea lions? That is another pile of crap. The pier is too high for sea lions to be seen within reach of the pier, incidentally. That's another lie. What am I, the only one in San Francisco who's not on medication? Where is the media on this? Anyway, the gun belonged to a federal agent. Which federal agent? Which moron federal agent would leave a gun in a car? And by the way, now that we're speaking about the gun used to kill the woman belonged to a federal agent, how did they get that information so quickly? Normally, forensics takes quite a while. Did they find the gun? I thought the gun wasn't really found. I know that the divers from the SFPD were in the muck. I just love everything is made believe like it's clean and upfront. I feel like I'm living in the meltdown of the whole civilization. The only one making sense is me and Donald Trump. Anyway, going back to the gun, how did they find the gun so quickly? And by the way, there's another little fact that I may be the only sane man on earth who remembers all the details that were reported. The young lady who was shot by this illegal alien from Mexico said that they heard a pop, and then she said she didn't feel good. Now they say it's a 40 caliber handgun? Anyone out there own a 40 caliber handgun? 40 caliber handguns don't make a pop. They make a boom. And by the way, if you're shot with a 40 caliber handgun, you kind of die immediately. So I don't believe it. What was she shot with? What was the caliber of the gun that was used to shoot her? If it was a pop, it was a low caliber gun. 22, 25, 32, maybe. Maybe you'd hear a pop. And even a 32 makes more than a pop. It makes a boom. I don't believe the whole story. It stinks to high heaven. Something is wrong. It stinks to high heaven. It stinks worse than City Hall does, where Boss Tweed runs the city. Whoever Boss Tweed may be today in San Francisco. I know his name isn't Tweed, nor do I think he wears Tweed. Here's the next story on MichaelSavage.com. Obama to bus minorities into white suburbs is the question mark. Now, of course, he's not going to bus minorities into white suburbs. No, he's going to force minorities into white suburbs to make sure they're no longer white suburbs. See, he's got a lot of work to do in the time he has left. He has a lot of work to do. Greece on edge of catastrophe, that we know. There'll be riots and chaos. What do I care? What, the bums don't want to work? You're going to pull back on their pensions and their benefits and they're going to riot? Let them riot. Let them riot. What do I care what they do in Greece? What does that have to do with me? That's what most people think. If they can't afford it, let them stop spending so much. I mean, how much baklava can the world buy? How much baklava can the world buy? On the left front page of Michael Savage, there's the best-selling novel, Countdown to Mecca. And you really should take a look at it. Under the threat of a third world war, nothing matters except the mission. It's a great novel. I expect many of you have read it because it sold quite a few. Here comes the gold. Now the gold. And it's directly related to what's going on in San Francisco. Why? I could say it's putting your head in the sand. I could say it's liberalism is a mental disorder. But it's all part and parcel of the same insane philosophy. Let me explain something to you. Radical Islam has been at war with the world for at least 1,000 years. It has never stopped in its war against other religions and less, let us say, pure Muslims for 1,000 years. And to bring them in as he is doing is doubly insane. Why would you bring in Muslims at a time when there is so much Muslim terrorism around the world? Why would you bring in 160,000 Somalis, half of whom are Muslims, none of whom have been vetted for terrorism? Why would you do that if you worried about homegrown terrorism? Would you bring them in because you are sure all of them are clean as the driven snow and they'll not radicalize their community? Do you know how many radicals have come out of the Somali community in Minnesota where you're dumping another 160,000 Somalis? Who is behind this? Well, the same insanity of a sanctuary city is being seen on a federal level with Obama as the chief and sanctuaryer. He is the chief man of sanctuary cities. He is creating America as a sanctuary nation. We have taken in more immigrants than all nations on earth, and the lifeboat is sinking, in case you don't know it. Now, I can make this a fiscal discussion if you're uncomfortable, before you nervously change the dial. The China stock market is imploding right now. They have exceeded their capacity to continue the scam of develop, 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 develop. The China stock market is imploding. It's collapsing. And God forbid that thing goes down. They're liable to come and call the notes on the U.S. debt. Tell me what will happen then. Will it be like Greece? Have you heard what happened in Greece lately? Where the communist government of Greece is defiant and unwilling to change their policies with regard to the handouts that they've been receiving from the productive citizens of Germany and France. The bums in Greece don't want to work. They want 12-week vacations, free disability, free this, free that, just like America, where 95 million Americans don't work. Did you hear that? 1 out of 5 Americans are on welfare. And he's bringing in more welfare recipients from Somalia and Syria now. Who is going to pay for this? The answer is nobody. This government will collapse like Greece is going to collapse. Margaret Thatcher put it best, the great, great thinker Margaret Thatcher, when she said, socialism is a great system until you run out of other people's money. Well, Greece just ran out of other people's money. And so the gangster communist regime in Greece said, No, we're not going to rein in our spending. We're not going to cut back on pensions. We're not going to cut back on medical disability. By the way, one island of a small population, 800 people claim blindness to collect disability. Did you hear that story? I guess you didn't catch that one yet. They were investigating it, and they found out that 800 people on a tiny island were claiming blindness to collect disability payments in Greece. Can you believe this? They said they were totally blind, and yet they were seen driving their cars. Do you know how many Americans are on federal disability in this country? About 12 to 15 million Americans under Obama have claimed to be disabled, and they're collecting disability checks from the federal government. It's all well and good, the welfare state, until you can't afford it anymore. And guess what happens then? The country collapses. And guess what happens then? Exactly what the government wants, which is civil war and insurrection. And then guess what happens then? There's martial law and autocratic control. And guess what happens then? There are internment camps. And guess what happens then? It's done for the safety of the citizenry. And guess what happens then? Well, you can figure it out. You're a smart boy. All you liberals can put two and two together. But you feel, you know what? Even if this crazy man is right, what, so what? We run the country. It'll never happen to us. They won't arrest me, you're saying to yourself, because you're too powerful. You are above the law. You've been look what you've been getting away with. If you could get away with what you've been getting away with, do you actually think if the government collapsed, they're going to come for you? Of course not. They'll come for the returning war veterans. They'll come for the Christians. They'll come for anybody but you, because you've got the army of the night behind you. And who is the army of the night? It's the illegal alien gangs that you have behind you. It's those who burned the city to the ground in Baltimore behind you. That's who you have. Those are your armies. You think we don't know it? We understand your entire plan. We understand why you feel protected. We understand why you let a murder like this go unindicted. We understand all of this. And so I've given you my opinion. And I've shown you how it's connected to the insanity of liberalism, the philosophy itself. And I've shown you how Obama is the ultimately insanest person on the planet. For him to say that they have to win hearts and minds against Muslims who have been at war for 1,000 years, Islam itself has been at war with Christianity, at war with Hinduism, at war with Judaism for 1,000 years. Now, it is true that we have Muslim allies, namely Jordan and Egypt, but they are Obama's antagonists. He doesn't want Muslims who want to fight the radical Islamists on his side. He won't help Jordan. He won't help Egypt. Why not? They oppose the Muslim Brotherhood because they know what vicious louts they are. They know what murderers the Muslim Brotherhood is. So why does Obama not help Egypt and Jordan when they're asking for heavy weapons to be brought into the Kurds to help the Kurds fight ISIS? I'll let you put two and two together, all you smart straight-A students from Stanford. You could figure out. Let's see. He says Muslims aren't the cause of world terrorism, and we have Muslim allies who are fighting ISIS, Jordan and Egypt. They're begging for weapons, and he won't give them the weapons, nor will he permit them to fly the heavy weapons directly to the Kurds in southern Syria. He's insisting that they fly the heavy weapons through Baghdad. Figure out why and which side Obama is on, and then once you do, get back to me. This is Professor Savage taking a quick break.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
The Savage Nation is sponsored by Swiss America, the only company I trust with my financial future. Call 800-289-2646 or SwissAmerica.com. If you've got America is still reeling from the Mexican illegal who shot that poor young lady on the wharf, and I'm getting reports that are really a little bit weird. Like one person emailed me and said he's a Mexican Lee Harvey Oswald taking the rap for an ICE agent. Now, I don't know what to make of that. Why would an ICE agent shoot a tourist, or let's say a person walking on the wall? What's that about? Are they just trying to trigger panic in the population? Are they pushing for gun control? Because right away, the demagogue, Matt Gonzalez, who was the chief so-called public defender, a real extreme whack job leftist who was on the Green Party, a plant of La Raza. Yeah, La Raza gave him an award. He's now speaking out for the murderer, the alleged murderer. And Gonzalez sponsored a ballot measure, Proposition F, in November of 2004, that would have given non-citizens, meaning illegal aliens, the right to vote in local school board elections. I want you to listen to Matt Gonzalez, the public defender who's representing the murderer, on guns in clip two.
Every day in the United States, innocent people die through gun accidents. In contrast to that, I can say that there are numerous studies, and my own experience supports
You're full of crap.
That immigrants in this country are
Liar.
Far less likely to commit acts of violence
Liar.
Than native-born.
Total lie. The data is the opposite. He's a liar, a nightmare, what they get away with in this city because there's no press. No press whatsoever. I have the data. It's the exact opposite. In fact, illegal immigrants are far more likely to commit acts of violence than native-born persons. Notice he conveniently lumps immigrants in this country with illegal immigrants. He makes them all one and the same. They're not one and the same. But anyway, put that aside. He's a plant of La Raza, just as Obama is a great supporter of La Raza. I've tried to tell you this for years. No one listens to me, except the millions who listen to me and buy my books. You want to hear the fact or not? Cecilia Munoz, M-U-N-O-Z, a radical socialist leftist, La Raza head, was taken right into the Oval Office by Obama years ago. She has been driving Obama's illegal immigration policies right from inside the White House. So what more do you need to know? What more do you need to know? But, on the extremist level here, let's say you want to talk about something nutty. Someone says to me he's a Mexican Lee Harvey Oswald taking the rap for an ICE agent. That's a juicy topic for a novel. If I were to do number four in the series of the Jack Hatfield series, the next one after Countdown to Mecca, which I said I wouldn't do, that's a good way to start the book. Innocent woman walking on the streets, shot by someone, some stoner Mexican guy. They put him, know what to say, kicked the gun, it went off, boom, 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 and made bang, bang, bang. And the next thing you know, all of a sudden, they're attacking guns in San Francisco. Well, I'm all for seizing guns of all of the people who shouldn't have them. Oh, yeah, why don't you have a raid of everyone in the city who's a member of a gang and take their guns away? Start with the illegal aliens and their guns. Start with the gangs and their guns. And end with the gangs and their guns. That's the kind of gun control we need, Matt Gonzalez. But I don't think that's going to happen. Not in this crazy city, this backwards city that the whole country's laughing at. I don't know what is going to happen. You know what's going to happen. That's all about guns now. It's not about illegal aliens. That's what they're doing. They're trying to change the argument. Even Hillary chimed in on the sanctuary cities idea. And you can see where she stands in clip number three.
Any city should listen to the Department of Homeland Security, which, as I understand it, urged them to deport this man again after he got out of prison another time. You know, here's a case where we've deported. He ends back up in our country. And I think the city made a mistake.
So now the city is being attacked by the feds. The feds are attacking the city. The city's attacking the feds. An innocent woman is dead. You ready for this one? Remember Obama and Holder's Fast and Furious? How do we know that this is not one of those guns? Because every one of those guns in Fast and Furious that Obama sent to Mexico under Eric Holder were registered, and we all know that there's a directory of those guns. Could this be one of those Fast and Furious guns that's come back to haunt us and kill an innocent woman and is being covered up? I don't know. But these are questions that only a legitimate government could answer. So I end my inquisition at that point. We don't have a legitimate government.
Savage.